prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله والصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Dear Islamic brothers, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, indeed, there is abundant rewards a person may attain by reciting large amounts of Durood Sharif, salutations and salawat upon the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Shaykh al-Tariqat Amir Ahl Sunnat Allama Mawlana Abu Bilal Muhammad Ilyas Attar Qadri Damat Barakatuhum Al-Aliyah has mentioned a very beautiful hadith with regards to one who can receive a lot of reward for his recitation of Durood Sharif. With reference to Al-Mu'jam Al-Awsat, the Prophet of mankind, the peace of our heart and mind, the most generous and kind, the owner of Jannah, the knower of the unseen, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, has stated, Allah Azza wa Jal sends 100 mercies on the one who invokes Salat, Durood, 10 times upon me. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatun wa salaman alayka ya Rasulullah. As soon as the blessed month of Rabi'ul Nur Sharif comes, Rabi'ul Awwal, affectionately called or known as Rabi'ul Nur, then springtime prevails everywhere on the earth. The lovers, the devotees of the beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam become excited and delighted. It seems that as if every true Muslim, whether young or old, is expressing their emotional feelings, their feelings of joy and happiness. The one, we can say, who does not express happiness upon this occasion, who else but Shaitan or his followers and his aides. When the darkness of disbelief and idolatry was prevalent in the world, a nur, a light gleamed in the sacred house of Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu ta'ala anha in Makkatul Mukarramah. And this nur, this light, it brightened and illuminated the entire universe. What was this light? Who was this light? None other than our master, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam arrived to bless this dunya, this earthly life, on the 12th of Rabi'ul Nur Sharif, at the time of dawn, and transformed the dark night of miseries, of difficulties, troubles, calamities and tribulations into the bright and soothing morning of happiness. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As soon as this nur, this light from Allah Azza wa Jal, that is Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, when it dawned, when he arrived in this dunya, in this earth, on the 12th of Rabi'ul Nur Sharif, those dark clouds of dhulm and oppression and disbelief were purged. The palace of Kisra, which belonged to the Iranian king, was struck by an earthquake in which 14 of its spikes fell off. That flame which had been continuously blazing for 1,000 years in Iran was extinguished. The river Safa became dry, and the Kaaba, which had idols therein at that time, began to sway, and these same idols fell flat on their faces and their heads. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Beyond doubt, our beloved master, the beloved Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, was sent as rahmah, was sent as mercy to all the worlds, not just for human beings, but for all creatures, for all creation, for all the universes. The day when Allah Azza wa Jal's mercy descends is indeed a day of rejoicing, celebrating, expressing your joy and your happiness. Allah Azza wa Jal has declared in the glorious Quran, Surah Yunus, verse 58.
قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ.
Translation from Kanzul Iman. Say, you, only Allah's grace and only His mercy on it, therefore let them rejoice. That is better than all their wealth. Subhanallah Azza wa Jal. The Quran itself is ordering us to rejoice over the mercies, the rahmat of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal's greatest mercy is what? Is who rather should we ask? Allah Azza wa Jal's greatest mercy indeed is embodied in the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. That is, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam himself is the greatest mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, from Allah Azza wa Jal. As clearly mentioned in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, verse 107.
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ.
Translation from Kanzul Iman. And we sent you not but as a mercy for all the worlds. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Haq Muhaddith Dehlvi, عَلِهِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ الْقَوِيِّ, has mentioned in Mathabata bis Sunnah that indeed the night of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is superior than that of even Shab-i Qadr. That is the night of Laylatul Qadr, subhanallah, which is one of the nights bestowed. Shab-i Qadr is one of the nights, he says, bestowed to the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. In fact, the night whose greatness lies in the advent or the arrival of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is more sacred than the night whose greatness lies in the arrival of the malaika and angels. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal. The 12th of Rabi'un Nur is the Eid of all Eids for all Muslims. Indeed, if the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam had not arrived into this world, there would have been no Eid and no Shab-i Barat and no Laylatul Qadr. In fact, all the glory, all the greatness of the world as well as the Akhirah, the hereafter, is by virtue of the blessed arrival of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have all heard of Abu Lahab, who was one of the uncles of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. However, he did not accept him as the last Rasul. He did not accept him as a Rasul at all. He did not take Iman, believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. Therefore, he died as a disbeliever. When he died, when Abu Lahab died, some of his family members, they saw him in a dream. He was in a very terrible state. And they asked him that how he was treated like this after his death in the dream. And he, Abu Lahab, replied, I did not receive any goodness after leaving you. Then indicating towards the hole at the underside of his thumb, he said, accept this as I am fed with water from this because I freed my slave girl, Thuwayba, radiallahu ta'ala anha. Shaykh Allama Badruddin Aini, alayhi rahmatullahi al-qawi, has mentioned that indication means that he is given some water. Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now commenting on this above mentioned narration, Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Haq Muhaddith Dehlvi rahmatullah ta'ala alayhi has stated in Madarij al-Nubuwah, in this incident there is clear evidence, credible evidence for those who celebrate the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and those who spend their wealth on this auspicious occasion. Abu Lahab, he was a staunch unbeliever. Yet, he was benefited due to rejoicing in freeing his slave girl, Thuwaybah, radiallahu ta'ala anha, upon hearing the news of the blessed birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Now imagine how great the reward will be for those Muslims who spend their wealth wholeheartedly with happiness and joy on this occasion. However, it is necessary to avoid songs and musics in Milad gatherings. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear Islamic brothers, dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, mark the blessed birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam enthusiastically. Commemorate and celebrate it with enthusiasm. Even a staunch disbeliever like Abu Lahab, he benefited due to his expression of happiness and joy upon the birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Then why not we, those Muslims who love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why will we not be blessed? Abu Lahab, he rejoiced over the birth of a nephew, not that of the Prophet of Allah. Still, he benefited. If we celebrate with joy, with happiness, Miladun Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, out of love and admiration, how can we be deprived of rewards? Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Islamic scholar saw that the Prophet of mankind, the most generous and kind, the owner of Jannah, the knower of the unseen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in his dream, he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dream and asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, do you like Muslims celebrating your birth every year? The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam replied, I get pleased with the one who gets pleased with me. Subhanallah. The beloved and pious mother of our beloved Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu ta'ala anha, said, when the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was born, I saw that three flags were hoisted, one in the east, one in the west, and one on the roof of the Kaaba. Another narration, migrating towards Madinatul Munawwarah, Zadahullahu Sharafu wa Azima, when the beloved and blessed Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam reached a place near Madina Sharif known as Mawda'i Ghamim, Burayda Aslami, along with 70 horsemen from the tribe of Bani Sahm, they chased the caravan, the qafila of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the intention of capturing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what happened? Remember? They were chasing this qafila, this caravan, with the intention of capturing Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. But he himself got captured and captivated in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and became a Muslim. He embraced Islam. Subhanallah. He then said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, we will welcome you into Medina Sharif with flags. Therefore, the horsemen took off their turbans, the Imam Sharifs, placed them on the top of their spears, and then moved towards Medina Sharif. Zadahullahu sharafan wa ta'zima. Therefore, anywhere in your locality, if there is any Madani Julus that is going out in the commemoration of Miladun Nabi, join it, express your joy within the confines of the Sharia. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the ability to travel in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, to celebrate the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in whichever way we can. Ameen bijahin nabiyin ameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Oh my beloved Prophet of mercy, oh my beloved Prophet of mercy, oh my beloved Prophet of mercy. beloved prophet of mercy.